Gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, welcome to a brand spanking new episode of SCA Rebellion. This is yours truly, the Jam Factor, Joe Samatos, and we are live from Manila, the Philippines, for a continuation of the SCA Climax 6 qualifiers. And, come on, again? No, why? No, more old people, Alexandra of old school, these old dinosaurs now making her way to the ring. Back in her day, there weren't any... Ugh! Wow, I'm so disgusted by this era of wrestling that I can't even say the words. Back in their day, they only had punches, kicks, chops, and the everlasting chin lock! Yes, remember back in the old days of the NWA where they would put you in a rest hold for what would be like forever? Right, who will Alexandra be facing? None other than Miss Spencer of the Pumpkins Heater Alliance. Miss Spencer, despite having her misadventures in UCCW, her and Candy King made quite an impact as a team, debuting as a team in SCA during the early episodes when the season started. And I was Spencer looking for an opportunity here. Like I said, the SCA Climax Tournament is one of those once-in-a-year events. Only difference is, unlike the other times where the participants are already set, you have to qualify and earn your spot. Oh no. 1950s, here we go. No, Alexandra has the ultimate advantage. Miss Spencer, the Taskmaster, a technical wrestler in her own right, and a pretty damn good one. You can have to take on the old school wrestling style of Alexandra. Betsy Classic tried to qualify for SCA Climax 6. Unfortunately, Misery was able to stop her. Old school couldn't stand against the woman who stands alone. And so far, this early going exchange of chain wrestling has been pretty evenly matched. There's a deadlock right now. Neither can get the advantage. And Miss Spencer gets the advantage there. Spencer's like, yeah, show me what you got, you old fuck. All right, Alexandra, bringing Miss Spencer to the ropes. I'm pretty sure Miss Spencer would not say that. She's a teacher, a very proper one from Canada. Very respectable. And look at that! Just baited Alexandra into a guillotine choke. She baited that dinosaur with the oldest trick in the book. But it was not enough to put the old school one away. Oh, there's the Mongolian ear slap. And Spencer making her respect the knee. And again, making her respect that knee, man. Oh, Miss Snapmare getting her the everlasting chin lock. So then the everlasting gobstopper, it's the everlasting chin lock. Trying to wear down this old dinosaur. And unfortunately, the old dinosaur is still breathing. Chop! Uh-oh. Look at this. Look at this old-school Russian leg sweep. And now just stomping. Nothing fancy about that. And now look at this. Look at this ground handle. Look at the overcome doing a handstand as she's doing it. And then going right back to that ground headlock. And there's the end at the nerve hold. The trap working on those trapezius muscles, trying to wear her down. Who knows? Maybe she was taking lessons from Ming. Now Spencer trying to... Oh, look out! Arm drag! Nice counter there by Miss Spencer. Now Spencer with the arm wringer whip. And now quickly grabbing her by the bun in her hair and giving her a beautiful European uppercut. Now Rapinoe's got the head scissors and is now just delivering elbows. Using the point of those elbows on her skull. Hoping to beat her so bad she ends up back and she wakes up in the 1950s. And there's a back body drop. That's the oldest of all old school wrestling moves. Forearm. Oh, she tried to go for a knife edge, and Miss Spencer blocks it, gives her the kitchen sink. A deadly knee into the gut. I have to say, ladies and gentlemen, these qualifying matches have been extremely entertaining and very interesting. That added twist of you have no idea who your opponent is going to be has added that unpredictability factor, and not even a one. Spencer's going to have to do a lot more than that to put her away. But so far, this has been all Miss Spencer right now. Snake Eyes! Another clubbing blow got her pinned down to the corner. And now got her up for another Snake Eyes! Got her with another Snapmare. Is running next snap. Spencer really in control right now, really dominating this match. One, two, no. Alexandra still has some fight left in her. Oh, look at this. Bringing her down to the canvas and just driving her back into the center, driving her knee into the center of the back. And now once again going right back to the pin. We didn't really get much out of it. Now what's she doing? Got the double underhook. Caught her with that butterfly suit, double underhook suplex. Miss Spencer really in the driver's seat. And looking like she's going to try to end this early. Oh, wait, there's a jawbreaker there by Alexandra. And Alexandra with a bat with a rib breaker. Got her by her legs. What has she got in mind here? elbow right to the leg. Slap. One of the five fingers. Say to the face. And a shoulder block. And they're going right back to that head, ground headlock. And being super cocky and doing a headstand. Yeah, turning her over on her tummy. Didn't have anything in mind. Waiting for her to get back up to her feet. Decides to give her a swinging neck breaker instead. Don't tell me she's going to try to win this match with basic maneuvers. Oh, they only got a two. Now, Irish Whip setting her up for the ride. I don't know what she was going for, but it failed. And really badly. Spencer taking advantage of the situation. There's a knee. Now she sets Alexandra for a ride. And catches her with a deadly Samoan drop.
Talk about the big turnaround.
Now clubbing blow. Wait, there's a parry by Alexandra. And Alexander got a hold of Miss Spencer now. And going right back to that, to those ribs. She's making her feel the power of old school wrestling. That's all we did in the 1950s. We gave people clubbing blows and punches and chops and never-ending arm leg locks and arm holds. One, two, no. Alexander still has some, no, Miss Spencer still has some fight left. Oh God, the most basic of moves, the deadly body slam. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Don't tell me she's gonna end this match with a body slam. Get the hell out of here. No. The day somebody loses to a body slam is the day they lose all credibility as a wrestler. Spencer's not sure what she wants to do. But she can get her up for that vertical suplex. Oh, wait a minute. Capture suplex! Miss Spencer quickly going for the cover. One, two, no. Alexandra has a lot of fight left in her still. Oh, wait a minute. Setting her for the ride. There's schoolgirl, no, rope break. Chomp. Oh no. Oh God. Oh no. Pulling pile driver. That might be all. One, two, no. And Alexander cannot believe it. She can't believe Miss Spencer survived the pulling pile driver. Irish Whip, and no, wait, but there's a jawbreaker there by Miss Spencer. Spencer turning her around. Now turning her right back. Snapmare. Going up to the deadly second rope, the dangerous of all ropes. It drops a forearm. Oh, she's looking to put the nail in the coffin here. No, there's a shot to the ribs by Alexandra. And Alexandra going to try again for the schoolgirl again. Rope break. Try again, Jeep. Now sending her into the apron. And she's gonna suplex her back into the ring. Match is really taking its toll. It drops the deadly fist drop. And now going right back to that trapezius hold. Just working on the nerves. Wearing her down. And now go up to the deadly second rope again. Wait a minute. Miss Spencer back up to her feet. Oh man, she takes her down off the second rope. Takes her to the corner. What has Miss Spencer got up her sleeve here? Get to her on the top rope. Shot to the back. Oh no. Oh god, oh man. 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 Avalanche German suplex off the top rope. One, two. Oh, forget about it. That's a three. Supreme victory right here in Manila, the Philippines. Big win there by Miss Spencer. Look at the highlights here in the Extreme Replay. There was that neck breaker. Now we got one. There was a time where Miss Spencer had Alexandra pinned down, trapped in the corner. Just giving her a series of snake eyes. There's the deadly Snapman and that running neck snap. That was another failed pinfall attempt, though. They got her for that vertical suplex. And I believe this is where she went for the capture suplex. I thought that would have been it right there, but fate would not let that happen. And then here's where endgame happened. Shot to the back. Going up the top rope and giving her that avalanche German suplex. And that was some distance she threw her. She did it so hard that Technicolor was restored back to the arena. And to your screens, wherever you're watching it, whether it be on your mobile app, your Xbox, your PlayStation, or your PC. Great win here by Miss Spencer. And ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back as we go into our next qualifying match in a few moments. Ladies and gentlemen, here we go with our next SC Climax 6 qualifying match. As the lights go dark, and here comes Idolo of Golden Glamour, selfie stick in hand, sending her selfies of herself on Twitter, on Facebook, on subreddit, on any social media website, and probably even on 4chan. Let's hope not. So Laura has tried to qualify for SCA Climax 6 against the Ravishing Crystal, but unfortunately, she lost to the Ravishing Crystal. And will fate happen? Will this happen to Idolo too? Or will Idolo win and successfully qualify for the tournament? The question is, who is going to be her opponent? Who is she going to face? Man, she is really full of herself, isn't she? She's really loving that selfie stick, bro. Now it gets really interesting here. Idolo's opponent is Hima Kasuya, a former SCA original. Hima Kasuya made her appearance. She tried to challenge. She knocked it for the TV title. She was unsuccessful in that attempt, but she showed that she no longer had the ring rust and is looking to jump into SCA Climax 6, but that's if she can beat Idolo and qualify successfully. And this is going to be a very interesting clash of styles here, a battle of wits. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the thriller in Manila, the battle in Manila, the Philippines, Italo, Hina Kasmai, and here we go. Now they're just showing off to each other here. Oh, there's an Italo starts with the first attack. Hina responds. They tie up. There, now got her in a wrist lock. So wait a minute. Trying to battle for wrist control. And Italo getting the victory there. In that exchange. She's like, yeah, I'm bad. Now we go battle number two. Hina's got her pinned down to the corner. The referee's going to have to separate them here. We're going to make a clean break. Okay, there's a clean break. Everybody lock up back up again. This time, got her from control from behind. Takes Italo down to the ground. So far, Hina is winning these exchanges here. Wait, Italo. Got a head scissors. And now punching her in the gut. He's giving her clean shots in the midsection. Wait. They're going back to ground control here. Hina. And Hina with another ground punch. And now we're back on stand-up. Wait, go behind there by Italo. And Italo with the atomic drop. When your gluteus maximus makes contact with your opponent's knee, the knee will win. Every single time. Unless she was going to go for a suplex, but then went right for a swinging neck breaker instead. Going for a quick cover here. No, not even a one. Way too early for covers. And we're not talking about covers, the bed sheets. Irish whip. No, there's a jawbreaker there by Hina. Now Hina throwing Italo into the corner. And a big elbow. Stumping. What big elbow there, right to the forehead. Quickly going for the early pin attempt. One. Only got a one. But that was a big elbow. That really did connect. That connected really well. But it was a double throat chop. Catcher with the clothesline. Nothing fancy about that. Going for the cover again. Not even a one. Hina trying to go for multiple pinfall attempts here. Now Italo's got Hina pinned down in the corner. He's going for a multitude of blows, and oh man, use your gluteus maximus to the face. Trying for a drop kick. That attempt did not work out. So far, Italo with the early advantage right now here on Hina. And oh, wait a minute. Look at this. There's Hurricane Rana pin. One. No. Only a one. Stomping ahead. Now, quickly going up the top rope. Hina with a running elbow to the legs. Temporarily stopping her as she's going for the Muscle Buster. Stop right there to the midsection. Hina quickly taking advantage of the situation. Going up to the top rope. She got a mine here. 450. No. Italo got out of the way of the 450 splash and now going right into a single leg crab. This could be bad or good. And no. Hina able to get her way out of it. Hina lost the grip on the hold. There was a rib breaker. Cover. One. Only one. There's a shot to the throat. Knee to the gut. And now just going with stomps. And now Italo now going up the top rope. And dropping the big leg. Ilo Eva the time of her life right now. Sleeper hold up. Got a sleeper hold locked in. Two, no. Ida still has some fight left in her. Wait, Ilo, Irish whip. No, there's a shot to the mid, to the ribs there. Mahina and Hina with the DDT. Slot right to that lower back. Now putting her, sending her to the apron. Oh! Literally sending her, launching her to the outside, and look out! I don't know if that, I didn't get a good view of that. I don't know if she connected or she crashed and burned. Referee at three. And here we go. They're going to battle out here on the concrete floor. Oh! Spinning backdrop right on the concrete. The referee at four. Scoop slam on the concrete. And Hina, oh God, Hina going up the top rope. Oh, this is going to look ugly. Oh my God! Elbow right to the back. Man. The referee's count restarted. Hina getting a second win, just sending her face first into the post. Oh, once again, sending her right into that post. Again into the post. Referee at six. Now, stirring around the apron. They're going to hurry up and get back in the ring. Referee is at nine. All right, now Ito's back in the ring. Elbow right to the face, keeping her down with her shoulder. Ito looking for the gold, for looking for that speeding wheel kick. No, Hina with the counter. Hina countered it. Bulldog. What great timing there by Ito. I mean by Hina, excuse me. Hina now up on the second rope. No, she changes her mind. She wants to go up the top rope. She got a mind here. And fail. Fail. Epic, very super fail. Oh man, oh God. What a shot. What a vicious shot there by Ito, and now Ito going off the ropes. Not sure what she was trying to go for there. Decides to go for that knee instead. Quickly going for the cover. One, two, no. There's that elbow again. Getting her on the ropes, and oh, wait a minute. Ina now got her head on the other side, going outside the ring. She's getting ready to launch. Knees! Heel down from the knees. And Ina, look at this swanton! Catches her with the swanton. One, two, three. Hina. Hina Kasmai qualifies for SCA Climax 6. Now listen to some of these highlights here on the Extreme Replay. There's that elbow. That would be one of the first, I think the first pinfall attempt. Back in the game. Double throat chop. So it'll be from the short arm clothesline. That'll be another pinfall attempt that did not work out, did not succeed. That'll be the Elo with the knee, and that only got a two. And this is where it ended. Swanton, legs hooked, and that was all she wrote. Tina is set in stone. She's qualified for the tournament. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back in a few moments as we get ready for our next qualifying match. Our show here at Manila, the Philippines. Rainbow Mika makes her way to the ring for her part of the qualifier. Mika, who fought Sakura Hagiwara at Destiny Rebirth, nearly won. She took Sakura to the limit, but in the end, the women's champion proved that she was too much for Rainbow Mika. And now Rainbow Mika can try her luck here at the tournament. If she can win and qualify, the question is, who's she going to face? Wait a minute, Ryomo, and I had a feeling that Ryomo might be her opponent, and I'm pretty sure that Ryomo has not forgotten that Rainbow Mika was the one who beat her for the number one contendership for Death and Rebirth. How ironic. Ryomo, the ultimate despair. Look at this. Oh! Down low. Ryomo destroying Rainbow Mika. Look at, oh god. This vicious assault. All right, transitioning. There's a German suplex. Two German suplex. Ryomo just wants to destroy Rainbow Mika in very dominating, very terrifying fashion. Look, he's now going behind her again. Four German suplexes. Five German suplexes. Six German suplexes. Mika cannot defend herself. Ryomo now taking apart an announce table. Oh, it's not going to be pretty. She's took apart that table and oh no. No, oh! Brainbuster on the concrete floor. Rainbow Mika is not getting the shred of offense in. Uh-oh. Now putting her on top of those announce tables. Oh god, oh man. No, oh! The god! Jesus! As the crowd stupidly puts themselves over. As if they were in the match doing something. And now Ryomo back in the ring. Doing the same thing she did to her through the table. This time in the ring. With the leg hooked. And this was a flawless victory. Ryomo attacked Rainbow Mika cowardly from behind. With her guard dropped. Gave her six German suplexes. Put her through a table. Brought her back in the ring. And this is even with a brainbuster on the concrete. But this is how the Ultimate Despair rolls. And I know that Juko must be laughing her ass off. I know she must be grinning from ear to ear at the amount of despair that Ryomo has just given Rainbow Mika. After Rainbow Mika lost that big women's championship match, now she has the despair of not being able to qualify in this tournament. And now Ryomo is now the qualifier. And now everybody's going to have to look out, because now an Ultimate Despair is in there. And ladies and gentlemen, now it's main event time. And here comes a fan favorite, one half of the Nameless, former SCA TV champion and former one half of the SCA Tag Team Champions, Salvatore the Magnificent. Salvatore has been trying to get herself a shot at the Women's Championship, but Rainbow Meek kind of put a halt on that plan during the Road to Death and Rebirth. Salvatore has a bigger opportunity here. If she were to win, she would qualify. She was in last season's SCA Climax 6, the SCA Climax tournament. And she made it pretty far in that one. It was a tournament that led to the downfall of Fiona in the end. Who Salvatore's opponent is going to be. And here comes the very seductive, the very deadly Nurse Anastasia, one half of the Balance of Terror. Anastasia has officially just turned the wrestling ring into an operating room. Though the arena itself is no longer an arena now. It's now going to become a hospital the moment she gets in there. She's going to be using her moves as surgical tools. Wants to get her evil, seductive hands on the championship. She's got the opportunity of a lifetime here. So does Salvatore. Salvatore has been in past tournaments, has been unsuccessful. Who knows? If she were to qualify and compete in the tournament, maybe fate might be different for her. Because she has to get through this qualifier. You can say that these qualifiers for the tournament are kind of like the proving ground. You got to prove yourself to show that you are worthy. You have the right to be in the tournament. And so far, Salvatore trying to out-wrestle Anastasia. Anastasia with a punch right to the back of the head. And wins that exchange. Anastasia's trying to say, hey man, I'm a better wrestler than you. And Salvatore's like, screw you, eat a German suplex. Lock up again. This time Salvatore with the advantage. Taking her down. And her on the ground. It's a punch in. And Salvatore wins that exchange. As she does a salute. Anastasia's like, screw your salute. And Salvatore's like, oh yeah, I can out-wrestle you all six ways to Sunday. Right back for wrist control here. Now she goes with a punch to the back of Anastasia's head. Now got a hold on. There's a European uppercut. Another European uppercut. She European uppercutted her so hard she flew right to the corner. There's a counter there by Anastasia. Anastasia now going for punches. And no, Salvatore with her own punch. There's a snapmare. Going right for the everlasting chin lock. Anastasia with the jawbreaker. And Salvatore again with a punch right to the ribs. Salvatore building up a lot of momentum here. And Anastasia proving to be the momentum killer. No, wait, there's a counter. Counter breaker! Another counter by Anastasia. exploit to the Black Belt Demon's playbook here with a series of arm drags. And they're just countering each other right now. Anastasia must have really been studying up on Salvatore. Goes for a punch and goes right to a snap suplex. Quickly going for a cover. Not even a one. Anastasia once again going for the jockey. There's a DDT. Like I said, man, this ring has become her operating team. Anastasia's mind, she probably is thinking to herself, she hopes that Salvatore made peace with God before this bell rang. There's a knee smash. It looks like Anastasia is now going to attack the leg of Salvatore. She knows damn well that she would do enough damage to that leg, the Houston hangover will not be as powerful. She is bullying that leg right now. She's going to try to make Salvatore's life a lot more difficult. But Salvatore battling back. She's not going to go down that easily. European uppercut. That was a powerful one, too. Now, sending her to the outside. And what the hell was that? Salvatore got a little overzealous there. Look out! But she made up for it. That will not go to Botcha Glitchamania. Moonsault off the apron. Oh, wait, look at this. Roaring European uppercut. Now, going up the top rope. Oh! Man! Salvatore is doing the aerial assault as she salutes to her fellow soldiers. Salvatore being a little bit too distracted here. She dropped her guard. There's a back break. And I don't know what the hell that was, but whatever it was, it put Salvatore down. And now Anastasia going right back to the assault of the leg. Another knee smash. This time stomping on the leg. Now doing a single leg, just making things a lot worse. Did you guys know that a single leg is more damaging than a Boston Crab? Even though the Boston Crab works on the legs and the back. I know, crazy, right? I don't know what that was, but Salvatore blocked it. Backbreaker. And I tried to put more pressure on there. Salvatore is showing that she still has a lot of fight in her. It's not like this isn't the first time her leg was ever assaulted. She has slapped it. Oh, man! And now going to continue the assault on the leg. Uh-oh. It might be criminal cutter time. That must be what Anastasia must be waiting for. Criminal cutter. She's got her. There's the criminal cutter. Leg hooked. One. Two. No! And it's Salvatore in trouble. Anastasia up on the top rope. Elbow on the back. Both women now trying to get back up to her feet. But Anastasia, the quicker of the two. And now working back on the leg. and she is making it her mission to make her life a living miserable hell right now.
Going right back into the sugar leg crab. And Salvatore finally getting Anastasia off her.
Now bringing her to the rope. Now wait, look at this. Off the rope with a European uppercut. Bringing her right again back to those ropes. She's going to try it again. And no. Anastasia's got her on the apron. Wait a minute. There's a sunset flip by Salvatore. Sunset flip. One. Two. No. Punch. Punch. Knife edge. European uppercut. A combination of strikes. And there's a cover. One, two, no. Stay on her, Salvatore. Oh no, it was a face buster by Anastasia. Anastasia just might have retaken control of this match. And there's the morgue. Oh, it's putting so much pressure on the back. Now she's bringing Salvatore to the corner. Putting her on the middle rope. And look at this. Just choking her on that middle rope. And now going up the top. With double knees. Lateral press. One, two, no. Look at this, how arrogant can you be? Just laughing at Salvatore right now. Oh, she's got her. Here we go again. Criminal cutter. It was so humiliating for Salvatore, he even made a highlight. One, two, no! Shoulder! Salvatore barely got her shoulder up. And now look at his Anastasia, going back up the top. And Salvatore's like, nuh-uh. Oh, wait a minute. Look at this. Oh, no. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, my God. Oh, my God! Salvatore must have gotten her second win. She's going up top. Knees! And the crowd is literally on their feet for Salvatore. Wait a minute! Magnificent Destroyer! Going back up to the top rope. Anastasia. And elbow to the back. Take advantage of that opening German. And Salvatore going to try it again. Going up to the top. Could it be time for me? Houston hangover! Houston hangover! Salute! Cover! One, two, three! Salvatore qualifies! She survives the operating room. What a match! What a battle here. Bellator had to fight her way out of the hospital. It was the first criminal cutter there by anesthesia. Yeah, this was definitely a battle of attrition. With the sunset foot counter there by Salvatore. Well, this was very, I believe, just very humiliating. He's literally just laughing at Salvatore. We're going for that second criminal cutter. Here's where Endgame was that used to hang over. And that was all she wrote. And Salvatore is our next qualifier here for the SEA Climax 6 tournament. Who's next for the next set of qualifying matches? Well, ladies and gentlemen, we are running out of time. It's yours truly. Let's bring it back to Jason Montes. From here in Manila, the Philippines. And I'll see you guys on the next alliance.